With fires burning across our state, one Boise State professor is shining a light on the impact the smoke from all those fires could have on all of us, but especially the wildland firefighters. Shira Matsuzawa spoke with him about the potential risk and how we can also lessen that risk. Shira?
Gretchen, Luke Montrose wrote an article for BSU after compiling various research, including scientific data and literature, as well as guidance put out by wildland firefighter communities. And his article comes as the CDC has already reported that smoke from fires can make people more prone to lung infections, including the coronavirus. With wildfires raging across parts of Idaho and our neighboring states, sights like this of smoke looming in the air are raising a lot of questions and concerns.
Firefighting is a really interesting situation because we're asking them to spend quite a bit of time on the front lines of the fire, being exposed to smoke.
Luke Montrose is an assistant professor in the Department of Community and Environmental Health at Boise State University. Earlier this week, he published an article taking a look at smoke from wildfires and how it can heighten the risk of getting the coronavirus and put firefighters in even more danger.
That repeated exposure to these inhaled particulates that are very small and get deep down into our lungs, it has the capacity to reduce or suppress our immune system. And by doing so, it leaves us vulnerable to viral infection. And that viral infection could be the seasonal flu. It could also be a coronavirus.
Montrose says as we move into flu season, everyone, not just firefighters, should be conscious of smoke inhalation and try and reduce it as much as possible so we don't see a spike in viral infections. As for firefighters,
as far as protective equipment, very little can be done for the firefighters. And so what I would recommend to them is, when possible, stay out of the smoke.
He adds if a firefighter is working a 14-hour shift, hopefully they could have 10 or so hours outside of that smoke to give their lungs some time to heal and get some of those particles moved out. But what about those cloth masks being used to help slow the spread of COVID-19? Are they helping protect people against inhaled smoke? Not quite, says both Montrose as well as the CDC.
The particulate matter is very small. The cloth mask won't protect you from those.
So how small is small?
2.5 microns in diameter. That's about 1/50th the size of a grain of sand.
Montrose says right now wildland agencies are doing their best to restrain the virus. But much like a wildfire can spread, he too wanted to help spread awareness.
Our public health really depends on their health. And hopefully we're able to make it to the end of the season with enough crew members that they're able to do their job and keep the public safe.
And when it comes to N95 masks, those can protect folks from the smoke, but because of the pandemic, they're in short supply. Montrose does have some other tips for folks, though. He recommends staying inside as much as possible during this time and filter air with either an HVAC filter or air purification system. Meantime, our meteorologists here at KTVB, like Jim Duthy, are also keeping an eye on our air quality, and you can find their updates here as well as online. Gretchen?
Yes, you can. All right, thanks, Shira.